Jeff Phelps.
Thank you, Jeff.
Welcome back to St. Paul's Youth Online for
Wait, Luke, I've got this week. Welcome back to St. Paul's Youth Online for Term 3. I'm Joe and I'm a Year 7 leader.
I'm Luke, I'm a Year 9 leader.
And we're super excited that you're joining us for another week online or in person.
Oh, spoiler alert. I guess it's not really a spoiler, they know they're there.
They're currently sitting in the audience.
So Joe, you're a Year 7 leader.
I am.
So how many years with the team?
About a year.
About a year. How about we get to know Joe a little bit better? We're going to play a game now.
Yep.
Word associations.
Cool.
You know how that works?
Sure do.
I'll say a word. Jo says the first thing that comes to her head. It's either going to be really funny or inappropriate. All right. Here we go. Sam Russell.
Children.
Mike Everett.
Muscles.
James Chen.
Asian.
Nick Davis.
Can't handle spice.
Salt.
Not spicy.
Pepper.
Spicy? According to Nick Davis.
Gemma Donahue.
Can't. There's nothing.
No words.
No words to describe
her. No words to describe her. Pip Witheridge.
Donald Trump.
Psalms.
Beautiful.
Proverbs.
Gets a bit interesting.
Leviticus.
Yeah, who knows.
Dating.
Not till you're 50.
Gary Koo.
Bishop. I went to say Archbishop, but he's not the Archbishop.
No,
he's only the Bishop.
Yeah.
Step up, Gary.
Absolutely. John O'Mullins.
Is he, you know?
No. Dave Kewen.
Bull.
Victoria.
Bogdan.
Victoria.
She's lovely, love her.
Awesome.
Not going ahead.
It is a bit in a roundabout way. Memes.
Hate him.
Oh. Jokes. Hate him. Singing.
Can't.
Crying.
Won't.
Daily. Red.
Bright. I don't know.
Chinese.
Red.
Carlingford.
Chinese. You know, yeah. Just
chocolate flavoured poo.
Disgusting.
Well, that wraps it up for that. We got to know Joe a little bit better, and we'll get to know a few more leaders in the weeks to come.
Yeah. This week we're having a similar structure to what we have had previously. We've got Bible reading, prayer, and a talk to dig deeper into God's word.
Yeah, some slight alterations for this week though. Year 7 to 8, you'll be receiving your talk from Big TC, Tom Cheeseman, Block of Brie. He'll be doing his talk online, video format. Hopefully he used a camera and not a potato to film himself. And then for years...
Has he done that previously?
Other leaders have. Other leaders have. We're in the 21st century and I'm looking at a 1 megapixel thing. You might as well be a Polaroid for all... Yeah, 1 pixel. It's just a block of colour. I kid you not, I got a block of colour once. It was real weird. Thanks, Beck Conway. All right. Years 9 to 12, a little bit different. You guys are going to get the Frenchman himself, the pain au chocolat, Ollie Baguette Mullins. He'll be preaching to you guys in person, in the flesh. How good is that? You know, like when Jesus returns, like, in the flesh, what? Let me touch him. Sure. And you touch the palms, you know.
There were nails.
There were nails there, but Ollie doesn't have nails there.
No, you can go try and pinch him, though.
You can't. 1.5.
True.
Yeah. Only John O'Mullins can. His brother.
Yeah, so go get Jono to pinch him.
Test if he's real or a hologram, you know? Maybe we live in a simulation. Okay, let's get into it.
Wait, Luke.
Huh?
Let's get into this.
Oh, I like that. That was good.
Hi, Salt. My name is Grace and I'm in Year 12 and today I'll be praying. So please bow your heads and pray with me. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are love. As there are still restrictions from the government, we pray that we will love and encourage one another by serving others and obeying these restrictions. Lord, during this time, we pray for those who may be struggling or those who may be lonely. We pray that we can be regularly looking out for them and checking in with them. Father, we pray that we can intentionally care for these people and to remind them of your great love and your powerful plans ahead for them. We commit all these things to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hi, I'm Jen from Year 8, and today I'll be reading from Galatians chapter 1, from verses 11 to 21. I want you to know, brothers, that the gospel I preached is not something that man made up. I did not receive it from any man, nor was I taught it. Rather, I received it by revelation from Jesus Christ. For you have heard of my previous way of life in Judaism, how intensely I persecuted the church of God and tried to destroy it. I was advancing in Judaism beyond many Jews of my own age, and was extremely zealous for the traditions of my fathers. But when God, who set me apart from birth and called me by his grace, was pleased to reveal his Son in me, so that I might preach him among the Gentiles, I did not consult any man, nor did I go up to Jerusalem to see those who were apostles before I was, but I went immediately to Arabia and later returned to Damascus. Then, after 3 years, I went up to Jerusalem to get acquainted with Peter and stayed with him 15 days. I saw none of the other apostles, only James, the Lord's brother. I assure you before God that what I am writing to you is no lie. Later I went to Syria and Cilicia.
Hey guys, so... breaking news. My mate Jeff just told me that aliens are attacking Sydney. Get out now, evacuate.
Sorry about that,
breaking news. We've just got word from the Prime Minister that aliens are attacking Sydney. If you're in Sydney, evacuate now.
Okay, so both those stories are a little hard to believe because the content was a bit crazy, aliens. But bear with me. Which report would you have been most likely to believe? The message that comes from some person or from the Prime Minister? In this letter, Paul wants to convince the Galatians they should keep listening to the gospel he previously told them, and not to listen to new gospels. In Galatians 1, 11 to 21, he tells us why we should listen to his gospel. Now hold up, first, gospel. A gospel is an announcement of good news that you can base your life on. Thanks, I stole it from Josh last week. Cheers, Josh. And then what's Paul's gospel? Well, we read in verse 6 that it's the grace of Christ. And in verses 3 and 4 of Galatians 1, we saw that this includes Jesus, who gave himself, died on the cross, for our sins in order to rescue us from the present evil age. Now, Jesus' grace offers us forgiveness and peace and a good relationship with God. Sounds good, but why listen to this gospel instead of another gospel? Well, Paul tells us why in verses 11 and 12. Let's read it together. I want you to know, brothers and sisters, that the gospel I preached is not of human origin. I did not receive it from any man, nor was I taught it. Rather, I received it by revelation from Jesus Christ. Paul tells us that his gospel is from Jesus. That Jesus appeared to Paul and directly gave him the gospel, even though Jesus was supposed to be dead at that point. Now, if this is true, then Paul is the best person to hear the gospel from because of who his source is. It's like the news report. Whose news report would you have been most likely to trust? One with the source of a random person, someone's friend, or the Prime Minister, someone with authority? Whose gospel do we choose to listen to? Well, Paul claims that his source is Jesus, the King of the universe who died for your sins and can appear to people after he was supposed to have died. But notice before I said if and claims, because honestly, Paul's not the only person to claim to get a message from God or Jesus. So why believe in what Paul said? Well, luckily, Paul knows we'd ask a question something like this, so he tells us why. How does Paul try and convince us that his gospel is from God? Does he use some sort of cool philosophical argument or big theological terms? Well, no, actually. He uses a different, powerful weapon. His story. Paul knows that his story is great evidence for Jesus appearing and giving him the gospel. Paul's first piece of evidence is his change. You see, Paul originally was a zealous Jew who hated Christians. He's not just making it up that Jesus appeared to him, because originally he hated Jesus' disciples. He was against them. We read here, he notes, how intensely I, Paul, persecuted the church of God and tried to destroy it. But then, in verse 15, God reveals to him Jesus, and his life completely changes. Paul changes, and something has got to cause it. It's like if you have water, and you turn around, and you look back a few minutes later, and it's ice. That doesn't just happen. It's evidence that something acted on the water. It's evidence that it was cold. Similarly, Paul's transformation from Christian hater to Christ preacher shows us that something must have acted on Paul, that something must have happened to change him. It shows us that Jesus revealed his message to Paul. All right, what's the second piece of evidence? Well, we see that Paul's immediate response is not to consult any human beings. Actually, in verses 17 and 18, we see that Paul makes quite the point that it was a while before he met with Peter and other apostles. Why? Why is this important, Paul? What's going on? Well, in this period of time, Paul was already spreading the gospel. Without ever meeting and learning from the main group of early Christians led by Peter in Jerusalem. So the gospel Paul was spreading wasn't from learning from the apostles like Peter. This is Paul's evidence that this gospel isn't of human origin. He didn't get it from teachers or from the apostles. He didn't get it from men. So where did he get it from? Third piece of evidence. While Paul didn't meet with the Judean church for a long time, we can tell that his gospel is the same as the gospel that the apostles in Jerusalem were preaching. You see, Jesus' friends, the disciples, for example, Peter, had directly been taught the gospel by Jesus. Now Paul comes along and preaches the same thing, just like the disciples who had got the gospel from Jesus directly. We read in verse 23 and verse 24 that the Judean church celebrates Paul. And they hear that the man who formerly persecuted them is now preaching the faith he once tried to destroy. Even though Paul does not know the Christians in Judea, they celebrate him for the work he is doing in the gospel. Eventually, he does meet with Peter and James, and the response to his ministry, as we can see, is positive. It's pretty amazing. Paul spreading the same gospel as the apostles without ever meeting them. Paul had the same gospel independently. Miraculously, he has the same message, a gospel that must have been given to him by Jesus. So Paul makes his argument as to why he must have got his gospel from Jesus. He had a huge change. He didn't learn the message from the other apostles or from humans, but he had the same gospel as the early church. So we know that Paul's gospel, the gospel of grace from Jesus, is legitimate and it's from God. What do we do with this? Well, Paul wanted the Galatians to know that they should listen to his gospel, not another gospel, because of who it was from. And I think it's similar for us. If you're a Christian listening to this, or someone who has decided to trust this gospel, take heart, be happy and encouraged. This passage shows you that the gospel you are believing in is a solid foundation. It's really from Jesus. If you don't trust this gospel yet, or you're tempted to stop trusting it, this passage wipes away any doubt about where it comes from. It's not of human origin. It's from Jesus. It's from God. You see, you can trust this gospel. This gospel of good news. This gospel that Jesus saves you from this present evil age and can offer you forgiveness and peace with God. You can trust this gospel. Now the question is, will you?
Thanks for joining us for St. Paul's Youth Online. It's been a brilliant time. Has it?
Yeah, always is.
You're 7 to 8. We're seeing you in the flesh next week, potentially. Make sure you register for that and get a ticket so you can come and join us for all the fun that we will have.
Yeah, we hope to see you guys next week as we dive into Galatians 2. It's going to be super exciting. We have... And then you're going to cut this together.
What?
Just wait for it.
Do you know what he's doing?
Nathan and Stephen.
Of course.
We've got Nathan and Stephen preaching to you guys next week. So that's super exciting. Until then, make sure to follow us on Instagram. Go give us a subscribe on Facebook and YouTube so you can stay up to date with the latest and the greatest. Jesus. Amen.
Hit that like button.
Joe Phelps, thank you very much for joining me as an MC this week.
Luke, thanks for joining me this week as an MC.
Unreal.
See you next week.
See you next week.